Today I'm going to show you some of the best hidden features of iOS 12. So let's get started. Thanks to Apple new ARKit 2.0, you can measure real world objects like tablet and desk using the camera on your iPhone. The new Measure app lets you measure flat rectangle surface simply by drawing a line on the live camera view. The awesome feature about this app is that if you simply point your camera at an object, it will detect the edges automatically and will count the distance on its own as well. Number second is manage notification settings from lock screen. Now you can manage notification settings for an app right from the notification view. You can turn off notification for an app, hide it from lock screen and more without going to settings. If you are not using an app or interacting with a notification, Siri will even suggest that you turn off the notification for the app. Third one is force closing app is just a swipe up. If you have an iPhone 10, you know what a pain in the ass it is to force close an app. You had to first access the app switcher just like you would on the other iPhones, though it's just a swipe gesture, not a double click on the home button. Then press and hold an app card to bring up the red minus button. Then you would either tap red minus button or swipe up on the card. Now it's just like other iPhone models where you just access the app switcher and swipe up on the card, no more pressing and holding the first. You can even swipe up multiple cards at the same time. Fourth one is you can create your own shortcuts. With the new shortcut app, you will be able to create your own Siri shortcuts so you can quickly start meditating with your favorite app using an assigned shortcut. While I haven't found the shortcut app yet, you can go into Siri and search setting and pick and choose from a few recommended shortcuts based on your current uses. When you add one, you can then type a new phrase for it that you can use with Siri. It is useful. Try this. Now if you are enjoying this video, then please do hit the like button right now. If you do, I appreciate that. So next one is you can create view screen time data. As a part of digital health initiative, screen time show a daily and weekly summary of your app uses. However often you pick up your device, which app are giving you the most notification and more. App limits let you enjoy the real world more. As a part of digital health, you can use app limits menu to set limit for the individual app that you frequently use. Reminder will tell you that you are almost out of time for the using the app, though you can ignore if it necessary. This syncs across all the iOS devices, so you can't cheat by using a timeout app on another device. Parents have more control. Thanks to the app limit feature, parents can now set a variety of app restrictions for their children's iOS devices. Parents can schedule downtime, which prevents kids from using the iOS device completely during set times such as bedtime. They can also see app limits per app by app categories. There is also the ability to set some of the apps to always work and like you already could before. You can restrict websites, apps, etc. based on age. Safari prevents data collection. While there are already some tools for keeping your data safe from third-party advertisers, Safari in iOS 12 goes a step beyond by preventing share button and comments widget on the web page from tracking you without your permission. In addition to that, advertisers can't acquire your device unique characteristics. What that means is that they won't be able to target ads based on your device model, and they will not be able to retarget ad across the web. Secure password comes to Safari and apps. This is one more reason why you might want to ditch LastPass, another third-party manager. According to Apple, unique complex password for all of your apps and websites are automatically created and saved in the Safari in apps, so you can use more secure password without having to remember a thing. Tongue detection in an emoji. You can now stick your tongue out no matter which emoji you are using. There is also wink detection. Number 11th is effects in messages camera. When you open the camera from the messages app, you will see a little effects icon in the bottom left here. Here you will be able to add filter, any sticker, an emoji or memoji. This is a really cool way to send fun photos and videos in iMessage, especially when you are getting memoji in the camera view live. Number 12th is OTP autofill. This new feature is going to be game changer for people who use two-factor authentication. iOS 12 will now automatically fill in one-time passcode received over SMS. No need to copy and paste or remember 6-digit codes. That's pretty much it, guys. I have discovered this much new, delightful hidden features that Apple didn't talk during keynote, but you get these features in iOS 12. If I missed any best feature, please comment down below. I would love to know. And thank you so much, guys, for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.